I'm sure if you ask anyone, if they miss home, I'm sure 90% of them, they miss home. It's always great for me to be able to come to my place, to my people.
2 years ago, he was a nobody. Now, he's a McLaren Formula One driver, and he's hero worshipped at home in Mexico. And we're here to find out who he is and what the people think of him.
It seems a long time ago. As a child, I was not interested in the motorsport. I never had in mind getting into Formula One. I wanted to be a football player at that time.
I had a big problem with Sergio. He told me, "Father, I don't like it, the racing cars. I love it, the football, the soccer." No. Sergio, he told me, "Okay, father, you paid me 500 pesos per race."
I had no interest at all. I didn't care. My dad did. My dad was furious if I didn't win. But when I went to England, I remember very well, I went to Brands Hatch, and I saw how professional it was. And it's where I realized that it's what I wanted to do.
I love you, Sergio.
He's a good kid with the people.
Good life, Sergio.
Mexican kids, everybody are loving to Checo.
Checo.
How are you?
I'm all right. How are you? Nice
good.
To see you.
Yes.
It's great to be in Mexico.
Welcome.
You're doing some filming today. Is acting new to you, or have you done lots of this kind of stuff before?
Yeah, I've done quite a bit here in Mexico. As you know, Formula One is very big, very popular.
This is scene two of Checo's day, the McLaren pit garage.
Where my career really started is when I moved to England. I went to England and I arrived into a great team.
Second place goes to the 21-year-old Mexican Sergio Perez.
Proud on them a lot because I started to really learn how to be a racing driver.
Sauber get their best ever result.
Sergio Perez has left Sauber and taken Hamilton's seat at McLaren.
You imagine for the father, no? I am very excited, I am very happy.
People don't realize how much you change when you change a team. It's a different world, it's a different category. The team itself is a great team. I'm very happy, very proud of my team. The problem is just lacking performance in the car, which is very difficult to compensate.
It's all over for Sergio Perez.
This is commitment number 6 of day 2 here in Mexico City.
The more successful you are, the more fame you get. So there's nothing you can do about it.
It's no surprise to see that you're a very attacking driver in Formula One.
You see now.
I'm seeing
you see the secret of my aggression.
This makes Sao Paulo look quiet.
Since I came to Formula One, I never cared about who I was fighting. For me, every single driver inside the track is the same.
Raikkonen's hit the back, I think, of Perez.
And I will fight them the same.
What the hell are you doing?
You are here to give the maximum for your team, and I will give my maximum for the team.
Perez has passed Button! Oh, he's not going to like that, is he?
I wonder how Jensen will get on in this traffic.
Next time that he thinks I'm aggressive, I will take him to Mexico.
We're on our way to the Autodromo Hermanos Rodriguez, which last hosted a Mexican Grand Prix in 1992. There's talk of a race coming back. If it happens, of course, that'll be Sergio's home race.
It's very important for the Mexican people, for the economy.
We're just coming through the main gates here. Here we are. This is it. This is the Autodromo Hermanos Rodriguez.
And Mansell going round the outside. Incredible!
The only racetrack where it could possibly come back now is this one here, but it's pretty disheveled. Look how this space is being utilised now. You've got tyres for goalposts, you've got a footy match going on here. The grandstand's empty. You can't help worrying that if this place doesn't get some investment soon, it's going to just decay and disappear in time. For there to be a Mexican Grand Prix, it depends a lot on Sergio Perez, I think, winning races and being a front runner in Formula One, particularly in countries where there's quite a lot of poverty and the tickets are very expensive. People are only really going to shell out in those circumstances if they think their man has got a chance of winning the race.
For me as a driver, it's very important that I give them the motivation and the encouragement to look forward.
Checo is the future world championship in Formula One, I promise you.
I want to achieve at least a world champion. I just have to be ready to grab my chance and grab the title, which is my biggest ambition.
What an incredible place. So much history, so much atmosphere. But for it to get a Formula One contract again, it's going to need one man to start winning races. And that man is Sergio Perez. And I tell you what, if that happens, I will not be sitting alone here in this grandstand.